book of Proverbs chapter 23 says, who has woe, verse 29 onwards, who has sorrow, who has contention, who has complaint, who has wounds without cause, who has redness of eyes, those who linger long at the wine, those who go in search of mixed wine. Do not look on the wine when it is red, when it sparkles in the cup, when it swirls around smoothly, and at last it will bite you like a serpent, and it will sting like a viper. Your eyes will see strange things, and your heart will speak perverse things. Yes, you will be like the one who lies down in the midst of the sea, or like the one who lies at the top of the mast, saying, they have struck me, but I have not hurt. They have beaten me, but I did not feel it. When shall I get up and go have another drink? How? Through the drinks, the enemy defiles the body and enters into that man and destroys his whole life. In another place it is written, the man who drinks destroys his own generation. Yes. How through drinks, through unholy, first to make the man unholy, and then he destroys that man. That's what we read in this book. Same thing happened to now what we have read in the book of Isaiah 37 of Hezekiah. So when Hezekiah received so much of deliverance from cancer, and he is going to live for 15 years, what he is supposed to do? He is supposed to recognize the Lord who has healed him and enter into holiness, meaning enter into the presence of God, celebrating the presence of God. That's why in the book of Zephaniah, chapter 3, verse 15, it is written, the Lord is amidst us, so you will see destruction no more. When the Lord is with you, the enemy cannot come near you. That is called the holiness. Holiness means doesn't mean that you have to be holy, holy, act right, or you have to do something. No. Holiness means basically moving with the presence of God, moving in the company of God, doing the will of God, preparing oneself, building up oneself, whether I talk, whether I eat, as we read in 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 31. Whatever you do, eat or drink, glorify God in everything. That is, you build up your life like that. Now, having received so much of healing and deliverance, suddenly he hears the Babylonians are coming. Why they are coming? To see how great the God of Hezekiah. He knew of glorifying God. As soon as the Babylonians come, he is acting, come, what do you want? You want to please them. You want to make them to sit over. Instead of keeping the Lord above, he is now keeping the enemies. And he goes and shows them out, look, I have this gold, look, silver. The prophet Isaiah came to him and said, stupid guy, who healed you? Who brought you out? Your mighty God, merciful Savior. And you have no grace to honor him. When the enemies came, it is my Lord who healed me. I tell you, what all you showed, the same enemy will carry them all from you. God gives us deliverance that we will deliver people. We will magnify the Lord. We will move into holiness. That's what happened to Daniel. When they said, you drink all this, eat, he said, I'm sorry. He kept up his holiness. He is not willing to defile himself. Means he is not willing to do anything that will hurt the presence of God that is in him. That is called holiness. Holiness means to preserve, to move around with the Lord. That's why the Lord said, The enemy is coming behind me, but he has no power over me. John 14:30, he said, the ruler of the world is coming behind me, but he has no power over me, because I move in the presence of the Father. Praise the Lord. I'll take you to the book of Job. Job chapter 21, verse 14 onwards. The Lord is calling Job when he lost everything. The only power that will keep him always in the presence of the Lord is to call upon the Lord. Whatever may be the disturbance comes, it is through life of prayer he should be able to protect the presence of God in him. So the deliverance comes from holiness. Holiness means keeping alive the presence of God, moving around the presence of God, and that happens through the life of prayer. Verse 13 onward, they spend their days in wealth and in a moment go down to the grave. This is what the world, yet they say to God, depart from us, for we do not desire the knowledge of your ways. When you don't seek God, when you don't pray, you tell Lord, go away from us. We are satisfied with the drinks we have. We are satisfied with the pleasures we get from the world. We are satisfied with the relationship we have with the people, the friendship we have. We are satisfied with the work we have. We don't need you. The enemy will work. He will not allow you to raise your eyes to God. From inside, the enemy will tell you, depart from us. We do not desire the knowledge of your ways. When you don't pray, this is what will happen. The knowledge of God will be stopped. When you stop praying, the knowledge of God will be stopped. And then the knowledge of the evil will come. Oh, one guy will come and tell you, "Arre, yesterday I had such a drink, man. It's very so sweet, you know. I took 3-4 beck, nothing happened, man. Even without soda, they feel so proud about it. That is the great thing. Aha, so today we will see. Today I will also come, we will have a wonderful time." What do they call it? Wonderful time. We will have great time. All wrong, what God can give it to us, all the terms, all this kind of thing will be given to the enemy's games. And man, I have brought the cigar from Britain, and nothing, you don't feel at all. You can go on at a time. 10 I finished, man. I see, I am great, man. I will finish 20 and show you. Let's see in the evening. Come on. You go from pit to pit. The enemy slowly moves you like a zero. From there, you are in 5. Little time you are praying, Satan has brought you to 0. From 0, he will take you to -5, -10. Again, to come back even to this 5, you have to come back -20 and again 5. You become very far from God. The enemy goes on, brings one after another. First he brings maybe the spirit of smoking cigar, spirit of drinking alcohol and talking, speaking ill of others. Slowly, spirit of prostitution, spirit of all, one by one, they go on, tie him, tie her. So, the first thing to bind us, the enemy will say, We don't need your knowledge. We don't need your ways. What, mommy? Going on praying. Stop praying. What is this? If you want, you go and pray. No, son. If you want me, I have seen you dying in your sin. If you don't pray, if you don't have light, what is left out is darkness. If I am your mommy, if I am your daddy, I have to lead you. If you love me, this is the way. We have to show. That's why a beautiful sentence is given in the book of Proverbs, chapter 22, verse 6. Train up a child in the way he should go. Train up the child not as you wish to go, or as you desire to go, or as the child wants to go. No. The word of God says, train up the child in the ways he should go. There is a way for the child to go, which God has kept. And when he is old, he will not depart from it. When he becomes old, so when he is young, you show what is the way of the Lord.